Leaders from the food industry issued this warning last week, telling Congress to take action on climate change or face a global food shortage. Leaders from companies like Kellogg's, General Mills, Nestle, Mars, and many others co-signed a letter published in the Washington Post where they warned about the threats that climate change poses to the food industry. The letter states that by the year 2050, it's estimated that the world's population will exceed 9 billion, with two-thirds of all people living in urban areas. This increase in population and urbanization will require more water, energy, and food, all of which are compromised by warming global temperatures. The challenge presented by climate change is going to require all of us, the government, civil society, and businesses, to do more with less. For these companies, that means producing more food on less land using fewer natural resources. And if we don't take action now, we risk not only today's livelihoods, but also those of future generations. Now, the food industry's hoping to convince our government to support strong emission reductions and a strong climate deal at the Paris talks in December. But they join other businesses, including the banking industry, as I just mentioned, the insurance industry, and companies like Nike, Johnson & Johnson, and Starbucks, who are all calling for support of a strong climate change deal. Experts have been warning us for decades about the havoc that climate change is going to wreak upon our food system. And they've told us that by the end of this century, we could be facing catastrophic food and crop shortages that actually could threaten civilization. But we don't have to wait until the end of the century to see what could happen. The evidence is already all around us. In Mali, armed conflict has been taking place for several years in the fight for food sources, as the country has been ravaged by droughts linked to man-made climate change. The country of Syria has been locked in a bitter civil war for the last 4 years, and this conflict has been intensified by food shortages and crop losses linked to climate change. California's drought has put a strain on America's food supply, and even the rise of ISIS has been linked to Middle Eastern farmers losing their way of life and being forced to join the militant group in an attempt to find a new way of life. The planet is running out of farmland, and it's because of climate change. Those who argue that point should take a trip through California, or better yet, go to Syria or Mali. Maybe a firsthand look at the tragedies playing out in those areas will be enough to send a wake-up call to climate change deniers that this issue is real, it's serious, and it's happening right now.